Today I have here 2018 BRP Can-Am Spyder F3T Limited. I will go from the front to the back and I will tell a little bit about the bike. But mostly I would like to focus on brand new LED display, which is a huge improvement for the BRP products, or especially for Can-Am. And also about this top case, because that's the first time I'm really seeing it. That's the first time I'm riding with it. And it's quite a cool thing. In case you would like to see the comparison between F3S, the beast that I'm riding, and F3T, there is a video that I did last year. It's gonna be somewhere over here on the top. Or if you would like to know a little bit more about these three wheelers by BRP, there is another video that I did. But before we will start, big thanks to the BRP importer and dealer here in Bratislava, Slovakia, company called ImageX, that they gave me this bike for a couple of days so I was able to run it and I'm able to give you this video. The link to their webpage, if you are from this region and you would like to buy Ski-Doos or jet skis or spiders like this, the link is on the bottom. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the Can-Am itself. As usual in these days, the Can-Am Spyder, it's delivered with the 1330 Rotax engine, inline three cylinder, roughly around 115 horsepower, roughly around 130 newton meters, top speed somewhere around 180, 90, 200 kilometers per hour, not miles. If you look on the bike itself, I think we are getting really, really close to the RT model. Just because how the bike behaves, it's still looking, I think, more sporty than an RT, but it gives you a lot of features that basically F3S don't have. If we go from the front to the back, basically this is black on black edition with all of those black parts. I really like it. You have the trunk as on every Spyder. You can fill in into the fully faced helmet. The shocks at the front and at the back, there are Zaks at the front. At the back is the shock as well. It's Zaks, but it has the air, automatic air adjustment or whatever, something like a pillow. And you can really feel it. I mean, the ride is really smooth. I did roughly around 300 kilometers today on really bumpy roads and it was real joy. What's different is that the F3 Limited comes with the foot pegs. I do like it and I don't on the other side, just because, you know, they are for elder people and I'm still young and sexy. But there is another thing, because of this top case, for some people it will be important to have the foot pegs, because you can much easier get on the bike. When you're just, you know, trying to get out from the bike without the foot pegs, you might be hitting the top case there. One thing that I don't like that much, this rear foot peg, you cannot really flip it and keep it like you barely see it. Additional adjustment is that the speakers, I think I was reading that in 2018 they tried to improve the quality of the speakers, so they are a little bit more adjusted towards you. If I'm lying, I'm sorry, but really I was reading something like this about the new BRP audio. If you have the top case, which is normal for Limited in 2018, you will have the rear speakers as well. And here's my experience. I'm not really the type of guy that likes to ride with music on. I prefer to have it in my helmet. If you are cruising and if you are in a city, you can hear it very well. I was testing it only with the radio and the sound was okay. But once I was reaching 80 kilometers an hour, let's 80 to 90, which is what, like 50, 60 miles an hour, 50 maybe, and anything above, you're simply just losing the sound. So I don't know, in a city it's a great thing. If you're on the parking lot, it's a nice thing to listen to that. But apart from it, I was listening to the radio and the sound was not really, really extra strong. Of course you have a shield in front. It can be unscrewed and you can change it for a higher one in case you prefer that. What is new? It's a of course, the new dashboard or the new display. And this is really a big improvement. First of all, the quality of the display. Today is a super sunny, super hot, and I was able to read everything that was on the display very easy. How you control the display, it's simply when you push, you get to the menu. It's very simple, home, trip, telephone, or any kind of apps. Left to the right, usually changing the music or changing the menu, up and down, usually the level of sound. What I like about the Limited, it's this piece of, let's say the back seat, not let's say, but the back seat. What I like about it, first of all, it's a little bit higher. So whoever is sitting behind you has the better view over you. That's the first thing. The second thing is, it gives you a little bit of the backrest luggage. The F3T with the top cover has roughly around 140 liters. I don't know how many gallons it is, but it's a damn lot. The RT model, for your imagination, is roughly around 165 liters. There is actually one thing I love about the configuration of the saddlebags, and one thing I really, I'm not that big fan, and I will explain you why. In case you come here to this top case, you can put the two fully face helmets, which is always nice. If you're going somewhere for day trip, you just put some stuff to your saddlebags, and always you have ready the top case for your helmets and you know, additional stuff. And basically my experience is that I was not even using those side saddlebags. What I was using only during this couple of days that I had the F3T was just, I was just using this top case. When I was riding, I started to notice the top cover roughly were around 170, 180 kilometers an hour. So that's something around about 100 miles an hour. So yeah, you do a little bit feel that top cover that is in there. If the wind is blowing, it hits the bike a little, but come on, it's a three-wheeler, so it's not that big problem as on a, you know, like on regular bikes. Beautiful thing about the F3T, that all of the like saddlebags and the top case, you are able to lock and open with one key only. This is something I cannot have on an F3S with my shed saddlebags, but yeah, this is really comfy solution, I like it. If we'll be talking a little bit about these side saddlebags, I have to say there is one thing I like and there is one thing I don't. The thing that I like is how the whole concept fits together. In case you are that type of guy that likes touring, that likes to go on a longer roads, don't like to go super fast, this bike is really for you. And I like how they really like wrap it around the wheel. You have those nice lights at the back directly on the saddlebags, and they kind of, you know, like nicely play with the shape of the bike. That's something that I like. Something that I like less is actually kind of navigating, or how to say it, like the access to the saddlebags. The fact and true is that on my F3S I have the shed saddlebags. They are big ass saddlebags. And I'm used to it that they are fully open, so I can squeeze anything in that I like. In here, they're a little bit smaller. And also the space and the navigating around it is not super comfy. So I went shopping and I had a little bit of trouble, so I threw everything to the top case at the end. But that's one thing I was not 100% super excited about. But then again, I mean, you still have your top case. By the way, the top case itself, roughly around 1,800. Of course, this is semi-electric, or let's call it semi-automatic, a gearbox, 6-speed. I don't know why would anyone go for a manual, just because how smooth is the transmission, how smooth it changed the gears. Of course, the first one is really hard hit, but then it just you know, switched the gears very smoothly, and it's about the joy from the ride. So why would anyone, even bother to have manual. I don't know, my personal opinion. Bike has the eco mode, never using that, but if somebody likes it, the bike simply don't accelerate that fast as usual in eco. You have cruise control, that's a nice thing. You have heated front grips, that's definitely a must have on a bike. Which is also nice is that you have the heated rear rails, or rails basically for the passenger. That's a nice thing. Yeah, we are really getting super close to the RT model. One benefit against RT, when you are refueling RT model, you need to lift the seat. You don't need to lift the seat with F3T. Yeah, just, you know, just a small thing on the side. So overall, what do you want me to say? I'm a spider rider. It doesn't matter that BRP gave me the bike. I like spiders with all their pros and cons. Definitely is a bike that for somebody, it likes, you know, a little bit of the comfort, but still is not expecting or doesn't want to have the RT model, which is really big. Beautiful bike, catch a lot of attention. Those speakers can be really good for many of you, so that's nice. I mean, after a rough riding with my F3S, I really enjoyed those couple of days with this spider. One more time, thank you BRP Slovakia for giving me this bike to test it. In case you guys has any questions, don't hesitate to ask me via Instagram or Facebook. There are the first links under the video description. Thank you very much for watching, and remember, always have fun.